And we are back. Couch Comedy Podcast. I am John. With me, as always, Tyler.
Hi, I'm here. Yeah, I apologize for not having intro music for this episode. This is the only episode so far that doesn't have intro music.
Second take, because I was so thrown off by the fact that we didn't have music.
Well, I'm not really sure how
to do it. I forgot what I usually say.
Because like, this is for the audio listeners. They're going to be just taken aback, really.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I agree. I mean, it's just unprecedented.
Tell the audience what we're doing today, John.
So we have an exciting episode. It's exciting. It's special because 1 year ago, we had a top five. That top five was top five Gen 1 Pokemon. And in the interest of my OCD, I felt like it had to be an annual tradition. So welcome to the Gen 2 Top 5 Pokemon presented by the Couch Company Podcast.
That was great. I was actually talking about the fact that if you are on Spotify, this is going to be a video podcast. So if you want to watch the Pokemon, they'll be on your screen, hopefully.
Yep, we're on the same page. Yep.
Yeah, we're doing this on Discord, so if the audio sounds a little different, that's why.
Shall we get started?
Let's do it.
With our first Pokemon here.
Sure.
Number 152, or in Tyler's perception of it, number one for the second gen. Chikorita.
I mean, I'm going to be relying on you a lot here, buddy, because you had me at Gen 1, Gen 2. I'll be surprised how many of these I actually know.
Yeah, I'll have to see how many I remember. I mean, I did play Gen 2. I think that was Silver, Gold, and Diamond, or Crystal.
Yeah.
And the main ones I played was Gen 3, actually. But I did have Gen 2, so I should remember them. Anyways, so we can see here, we got the number, we have the Pokemon, the Nun, obviously, which is the picture. And
sure.
Type. Here you can see grass, and then debuted. You might be saying, "Hey, John."
Hey, John.
This game didn't debut in 2017, and you'd be right. This is a Pokemon Go list, so yeah, the date is when it came into Pokemon Go. Anyways,
do we think Pokemon Go is more popular than Pokemon Gold and Silver?
Pound
for pound.
I have no idea. Maybe. I don't know.
All right.
Yes. Yes. I'm just going to say yes. Yes, it is sure. More popular, Tyler.
Sure. The pandemic.
I don't know. I just feel like it broke every record ever. So it was like, you know. Yeah,
people got back
into it. It fell off right. Pretty hard, right? Like, people don't play that anymore.
I thought so. I wonder when what gen they were on whenever the pandemic actually hit.
I don't know.
It's not important.
I thought it was just Gen 1 for some reason, but maybe I'm wrong. I never played it.
All right. So Chikorita. How do you feel about Chikorita?
Right, like every other Pokemon game, the grass type starter is always the worst. So this is no exception.
Cool.
Tyler, I don't know if you have any dissenting opinions on that.
Nope.
Pass. All right. We move on to Bayleaf. Better than Chikorita.
That's actually kind of a cool design.
Yeah, I like the design. It's better. Unfortunately, you never got to Bayleaf. Oh, it also tells you how to evolve the Pokemon. So you get Bayleaf by 25 candy, which I don't remember at all, but. Apparently,
well, that's
because
that's specifically Pokemon Go.
Oh, fudge. That makes sense. I was like, what is candy? That's Pokemon
Go. Right.
Anyways, Bayleaf. I like Bayleaf. Probably not going to make the top five because never used Bayleaf. So.
I'm going to just put it out there. Bayleaf, cooler looking than Venusaur. Or I guess Ivysaur would be the direct comparison.
Ivysaur would be the direct comparison. It's kind of like a... What kind of dinosaur
usually,
is this?
The second evolution this is kind of this like gawky teenager, and this one's pretty cool.
No, I like this. I like this. Yeah. What is it? A long neck? What are those called? Brontosaurus.
Yeah, Littlefoot.
Anyways, let's move on.
Meganium. It gets worse.
Yeah, it gets worse. I like the second one better.
That's a big pass for
but
me.
But you get the flower. They bud. But then you lose the cool kind of thing on top.
Yeah, and it changes color.
You don't like the color?
No.
All right, Moving on. All right, now we get to the important Cyndaquil. Now, I like Cyndaquil, and I always go fire, but definitely not my favorite out of the family of these three.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for example, when we compare it to Charmander, Charmander's infinitely better than Cyndaquil, so it's going to be a no for me for Cyndaquil, but I do, you know, yeah. I like Cyndaquil. I've used Cyndaquil, but he gets better.
Show me. Show me how it's better, because right now it does not look... I don't know. That's better? This is the quintessential teen
yes.
Pokemon right there.
Yes. Yes. Well, I think this is better than the first one.
Sure. You're right. You're right.
But yeah, it is a little bit of a trapezoid going on. I like the mohawk. It is very much teenage years.
I feel like I've spiked my hair within the like 2001
so,
era.
When it goes to middle Pokemon, I think this captures it pretty well. But yeah. Then we get to the big boy, Typhlosion. Now that's a hoss right there. That's a big guy.
It's a big
Typhlosion's
guy.
A beast.
Look, man, you
look at him. Look at that.
It looks like an overweight beef. Charizard. Like, it's not as cool as Charizard, right?
No.
So like
no. No.
I look at that as uninspired, personally.
Wow. All right.
I mean, look at the difference. Look from like Charmeleon to Charizard, you see this natural progression. It's almost like he just got fatter and lost his hair. It's like you have this team. He gets to be middle aged and suddenly
Tyler,
he's
that's
like
what
bald
life's all
and,
about, man.
Yeah.
You get fat, no, you lose your
it's
hair.
Too,
like
it's too close to home, man. I
what
can't.
You,
I,
like, what
that's
do
a,
you?
That's a big no for me.
All right, that's a big boy for me. That's what I give it. I give it a big boy out of 10.
It's like an edgy Snorlax.
Typhlosion is a beast. I want the record to be clear on that. All right, whatever.
I'm sorry. Did you want him on the list?
No, not now. There's no way you're gonna let him on the list. This guy's awesome. I love Typhlosion. All right, Totodile. Never been
easily the coolest. He's the coolest starter out of the three, right?
The first one.
Yeah. Well, no, I mean, like out of the grass and fire and stuff. Like, he's the coolest model, I think.
I don't know. Maybe he's just kind of like a little reptile.
Yeah, I guess. All right. Let's see.
He's happy
he gets
though.
Into.
All right, let's see where he's going.
That's like straight out of Mario Brothers right there.
Croconaw. I always pronounce these wrong too, so forgive me. I don't know how to feel about this one. It's like, I don't know, man. Super Mario Brit? What makes you say that?
He just looks like he's like the design.
Looks like the bad guy,
I apologize
right?
for people just listening to the audio. So hopefully if you're listening to this, you like Gen 2 and you already know who we're talking about. But it looks like Croconaw, I'm going to just use your pronunciation, Croconaw, looks like
Croconaw?
I don't know. Anyway.
Am I saying that wrong?
I don't know. I'm about to get this. He looks like the...
Well, here's the thing. Here's an interesting thing, too. Like, when you're a kid playing these games, there's no audio. Like, you don't know how to pronounce these things.
Yeah.
No, you know what I mean?
Hey, fair enough. Yeah.
Well, so
I'm just
know.
Saying he looks like a Koopa that got kicked out of the family.
Yeah, no, he's a little mad. What's going on with his teeth though? Like his teeth.
It's going in two different directions.
Make sense at all.
Poor guy.
It's a no for me, but
like he's a water Pokemon with like red spikes that kind of look like fire. It's like the artists were just kind of like just throwing stuff together. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, like, well, I will say compared to Gen 1, what do we have here? We have Squirtle. What's the second one?
Wartortle.
Yeah, I mean, he kind of sucks. Right?
We can move on from him.
Then we get to
Digimon.
Yeah. How do you say this? Feraligatr?
Yeah.
Feraligatr.
For alligator?
Gator.
I don't know.
Gator.
Move on. This is just embarrassing. It's like a
not
robot.
A fan?
No, it's a robot Digimon guy.
I wonder if this has to be the original art, right? It looks like the original
art.
Yeah. I just want to make sure we're getting
it's like that watercolor painting looking thing.
All right, Sentret. It's like a
this seems like a John guy with like the little
dude,
like the muscles.
I never I wouldn't call those muscles. I call those fat that. Let's call that the opposite. I will say, very adorable. I don't remember getting this one ever, so that's the only detraction, but it is very cute.
Did you have the ring. Gold or silver?
I had yeah. So I had gold. I was the gold player. My brother was the silver.
So, I gotcha.
Which sucks because Lugia is like way better than
No, no spoilers. I don't even know what you're talking about.
All right. Well, then how am I spoiling you?
Okay. No. Fair enough. I like this one. I think the style. Again, I'm only going by looks at this point.
You're keeping track of the maybes, correct?
Is this our first maybe?
Yeah, dude. I like the poofy tail, man.
Sure. The real kicker is whenever I go back.
Sad
to this.
He is though. He's so sad.
I look at that. He's like determined. I don't know if he's sad.
Determined. Yeah. You think he's muscular? Determined. I think we're seeing two different things here. All right, let's move on.
It's certainly possible.
So we have Furret, which is the evolved. Only 25 candies, by the way.
I don't.
You're playing Pokemon Go. I think the other one's more cute.
If we're going by cuteness, yes. I think this is a cool design. I don't see the evolution though.
Yeah, I mean either. Like it looks like a worm though. Like it's just the body's like one.
I mean it's a ferret.
Do ferrets look like that? I feel like there's a little more.
I mean they're not very. They're not
like look at the tail. The tail just morphs into the body, like one thickness. It's like a crazy.
I mean, look, our butts morph into our bodies.
Yeah, but it sticks out where this is just one solid
fair enough
line. Interesting. Yeah, I don't know how you feel. Know. Do you feel? I like kind of the eye black too. I like that. Yeah. I like the little very cute. Also cute. I don't see the you're right. I don't see like if you think evolution, like how does this grow into this? Like it just becomes like look at this is a tail, right?
Yeah.
So this just
I hope it's a sucks tail. Otherwise, into the body. That's completely cheating. That's the number one pick right there. That's not a tail.
Oh yeah. Well, there goes our friendly family rating for this one.
We lost that.
We lose that audience. All right. Anyways, so you see what I mean? Like the I don't know. Like the tail.
Yeah. I got you.
I don't know. All right. Whatever. We're moving on. Hootoot.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a new guy. This is a new one.
This is a new guy. Yeah, okay. It's a new one. Normal slash flying type. I think it's 1 foot. Yeah.
Foot. Okay.
And not a fan of this one. I never was. I don't like it's like scary looking to me.
Yeah, I don't no thank you.
Okay. Noctowl.
Okay. Like a nocturnal
owl. It's like an owl.
Seems redundant.
Yeah.
He has 2
like
feet.
The...
That's nice.
Yeah, he gets an extra foot. Definitely good for standing. I like the kind of horn kind of thing. I guess these are eyebrow horns. But
yeah, it's like a macaroni penguin.
Type
of situation going on.
Yeah, so I think that's cool, but I don't think it's.
I'm sure we'll go beyond.
Yeah, I think there's better. I think there's better. Ladybug. It's a ladybug. You can see that. Yeah. You know. A little bit uninspired off the top here, but that's okay.
It's like pig Latin.
Not uninspired, just maybe too inspired by nature. Maybe we need a little bit more creativity. I'm a no. I've never been a big fan of the bug types. So I'm just going to be straight up with you. So the bug types are
short of something like a Beedrill is pretty cool.
Yeah.
And like a Scyther, which I know we talked about a year ago, but yeah,
that's
on this one.
That's my bar for the bug type. So yeah.
Well, Ladybug didn't cut it.
Ledian.
Yeah.
Is the evolution of Ladybug.
Is this a final evolution or a mid one?
I think it's final. It looks like a Power Ranger to me, kind of.
Yeah.
With wings.
or like a boss in like a Mega Man game.
Yeah, I don't know. It looks like a good guy. I would say maybe a sidekick to Mega Man.
Oh, fair enough. Okay.
So I like the four arms. I mean, you lose an arm here, so just evolution-wise, that's kind of a detractor. You know what I mean?
Do you lose an arm or do you gain two legs?
Legs, yeah. Look at that. Also, your appendages change color. That's fascinating to me. And also, these look like thumbs, and then now it looks like tennis balls.
They just got nothing. Yeah.
I don't know. So...
Yeah.
I like the consistency with the antennas though. That's good. It just kind of gets bigger.
Yeah.
It's going to be a no for me.
That's a no.
All right. Anyways, spinner rock.
Nah.
It's a spider with a horn.
Or it's a dude with a spiked, you know what?
Okay.
Depending on how you
look
Tyler
at it. Really trying to, trying to get the, what would these be like, the feet?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't like that. We just have to move on.
Yeah. Arados. So this one's actually cooler.
It's cooler.
I like it. I like it better.
You get kind of. How do you get that? I guess the legs work out.
The legs work out, and to me, the back feet kind of go in and then come out the eyes. Then you get a look out here.
Yeah.
Actually, never mind. Are these the eyes? Maybe it moves back. You just get bigger.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know, man. I don't. That's a jump for me.
Horn gets weird. Really? You don't? This makes more sense than some of the other ones.
Sure, I see it. I see it. I just
this is easy.
It.
It's the same thing. Okay,
it's a different color.
That's a different. Okay, well, it's more poisonous. It's more dangerous. It's red now. Like green for red, go, red for stop.
Oh, is that how that works?
Yeah, green for like go sick, past like, me, red for stop.
Okay.
I'll end you.
Oh.
Bug poison.
It is worth noting that you have to use 50 candies in Pokemon.
Yeah, I don't know if we should factor that in.
Probably not.
A little zoom in for you. All right, let's move on to Crobat.
Oh, is this...
This evolves from Golbat. So there's... So this list is obviously just the new ones for Gen 2. So you have Zubat, Golbat, and now you get Crobat. I actually really enjoy Crobat way more than Golbat and Zubat.
I hate Golbat. So seeing his next evolution or its next evolution, I'm a big fan
of
that.
Look at him. He means business. He gets an extra wing. Now, in your, you know, kind of argument before, how do you get from that big, stupid face of Golbat to this? I'm unsure. Also, he changes color. But I do like the design of this.
Does he change color?
Yes, Golbat is more blue, I believe.
Oh, I'll give that a like blue and purple is better than red and green.
That's fair. Although, to me, I think a stoplight kind of disproves that theory.
Just keep going with the stoplight. Okay, yeah, no, sure.
The stoplight ties us all together. Without the stoplight, there would be chaos.
Crobat's cool. Is he?
I like Crobat.
Top five cool.
I'd put him in maybe.
Okay.
It's 100 candy. It's pretty steep, but I'll pay that. Put him on the list.
I love how my notes app is just like, you mean crowbar, right? And it's like, no. I typed what I typed.
Little fun fact. He's poison flying. I think that's a very interesting combo. Well, actually, maybe there was another one, but I like that. Because I don't believe the other two were poison. So you get that kind of, you know, that bonus there. I don't know. And he's 169. Nice. Chinchou.
What are we looking at here?
I don't know. It looks like it's KO'd. I like the little lights on the things. That reminds me of the one fish that has that, you know, the fish with the light.
Is this the first time that there's like a water electric thing? Are they starting to get fancy with their mashups?
Yeah, it might be the first pairing. I can't remember, but it is an interesting pairing. So, you know, usually those two things don't go together, right?
Anyways, it's
going to be a no for me.
I'm looking at the evolution. And it's like buttons for eyes.
Yeah, I don't know what the... Maybe because it's electrocuted itself.
It's just dead automatically. it's just a freak of nature. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, God, it's so dark. We're moving on. Lantern. So this is the evolved form.
Okay.
Kind of more of a fish. Only 50 candy. Yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, I think a lot of these Gen 2 really put on some weight. You can really see the kind of meat we're working with.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, In the wild, that's...
Naturally, that's not very aerodynamic or water dynamic.
No, I feel like
hydrodynamic.
This guy sinks for sure. I mean, look at this. You start with this. Like, this is this. You know what I mean? Like, you're gaining, like, three times the amount of body mass here. You know what I mean? Like, that's a big jump.
As much as I don't necessarily care for Chinchou, I think it's a cooler design than Lantern.
Interesting. Yeah, this seems a little like take the things away, right? And you're just left with a really fat fish with a mask. I like the mask, though. I do like the mask. But look how happy he is. He's very happy. Yeah. He's kind of giving you a wave here. I like that. All right.
Yeah, but like how can you possibly do that with it? You know what I mean? Like you can't swim. It's a little nubbin.
Hey, I mean, you can swim because he's a water type. But all right. Anyways, Pichu. Something a little more familiar.
Different from Pikachu, or this is?
Yeah, it's the I don't know what it's called, but the baby form or whatever.
So this is first,
or is it just different? I don't know. It's first introduced in Gen 2, though. Yeah.
Yeah, that's all right.
Don't you hatch? Maybe you hatch it. Maybe you hatch it from an egg, and then you can get it into a Pikachu. I don't remember how it works.
Yeah, so
I apologize.
Pichu, Pikachu,
Raichu. Yeah, I think that's how it works. Yeah, yeah. I like Pichu. Just a kind of cute baby version of Pikachu.
Yeah, it's
and
cool.
I like the ears are different, right? You get this cool black trim.
Yeah, Pikachu's ears you lose kind of like the black underneath the head, and the tail gets a little bit more intricate. Yeah, it's all right. It's cool.
Yeah,
it's
I like it. Maybe? Put it on a maybe list?
Put it on a maybe list, because it evolves into the most recognizable.
True. Yeah, that was our number two last time, last year. Yeah, true.
Got to represent.
All right. Cleffa?
Cleffa? Cleffa?
Cleffa?
Clefable? Clefairy? Cleffa? Makes sense.
Fairy type. Yeah. I was never a fan of this one. I don't know. I didn't really like it. I don't have a good reason.
Before or after? So this would be before Clefairy?
Yeah. Is that the one with the egg?
No, that's going to be not that.
Okay.
The egg is with Clefable, right? Or no, the egg's Chansey.
Chansey.
From Gen 1, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. Let me look it up.
I would assume this is first, and then goes to Clefairy and Clefable. It's like a little, you have like a Princess Leia vibe going on.
Okay.
I don't like, I'm not a big fairy.
Explore that.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not really big on the fairy types.
Yeah.
Personally.
Yeah, no, I'm with you.
So it seems like, and I guess for the sequel, it makes sense, but it seems like they're just kind of fleshing out a lot of like the two evolution ones. They're just like, oh yeah, no, there's a third one, or there's a starter evolution that you didn't know about.
Yep.
Yeah,
yep.
I'm starting to pick up on that trend. That's cool.
Yeah, that is a trend. All right, let's move on to Igglybuff.
No. No, that's like a satanic thing. Like the mark
the eyes
of the beast
are
is
so
literally
bad.
Gonna be that little swirl in the.
I do love the names though; they're always the best. Wigglytuff is like fantastic.
Igglybuff
and then Jigglypuff, Igglybuff, Jigglypuff, and Wigglytuff. That always gets me.
It's weird that
so
it goes
funny.
From buff to puff to then tough again. Oh, wow.
It's so funny. I don't know why. Yeah, these eyes are just horrific.
Yeah, something's off there.
Something's off. Togepi.
So is Togepi evolving into anything specific? Or is this a new
one? Togepi evolves into Togetech.
Yeah, but this is a net new Pokemon.
I believe so. Although, didn't Misty have this in the show? Which
I think so, but I never really watched the show. The reason why I asked that is this is one that I recognize out of all of these. Like, this is kind of like the first one. I'm like, oh yeah, no, of course.
Yeah, because it was in the show.
Yeah, but I never watched the show. So I'm saying it permeated the general culture more. In when I say culture, it's like whatever second grade culture, whatever it was.
Yeah. So this is obviously a very popular one. Another reason I really like Togepi is because it had Metronome, which is like such a fun move because it was any move. It was just a random move. So it was like really fun. So I'd put it on the maybe list.
Yeah.
If you're down for that.
Sure.
Okay. So here's the evolution. Togetic. And it just gets weird for me here. I don't really know what I'm looking at. Because look at this. This is like an egg, right?
Yeah.
I see this as like an egg, but then it just becomes its body. Like, look at the markings, just kind of, you know what I mean? Like, it the whole thing turns into an egg. It.
Yeah, go back up to Togepi.
Yeah. Yeah. See this?
Yeah.
Just the markings.
I don't mind the design. Like, I actually kind of dig the head and everything. But again, changing the color and it just.
They get wings, though, which is cool. I like the flying.
Those wings don't seem functional to me. But
an advantage. What do you mean? If a bee can fly, a Togetic can fly.
That's what Misty said.
Yeah. No, I think, yeah. Right. So, how do you feel about Togetic?
No, I if Togepi's on this maybe, I would pass up on Togetic.
Okay. How about Natu?
What
not
the heck are we...
How do you feel about Natu?
I feel
psychic
weird
flying.
About it looks like a Egyptian hieroglyph. That's how I feel about it.
Yeah, probably gets it. I never would capture these ones. I don't have a particular fondness of psychic Pokemon, but I would pass. But it's interesting. It's an interesting concept, I would say.
Yeah, I mean, hey, you got two legs. Apparently, two legs with Pokemon is a good thing.
That is true. All right.
Weirder.
We have Zatu. So now we kind of get some wisdom here.
you get something.
Yeah, I don't.
Is there eyes on there?
It's an interesting design. I think these are like the wings, right?
What if those eyes on the chest are actually the real eyes and it's just wearing a hat? Don't like that. It's weird, man.
Why don't you talk more about this?
I don't dig it, man.
You don't like this?
No, it is weird because like look at the feet and it's like it fuses together. It gets more strange. Like human.
Yeah.
And then I guess you lose your arms, or is it like the arms?
The wings are this. See this outline here?
Okay.
So the wings are the front design.
So it's like covering itself. Like
covering
itself. Learned modesty. Yeah.
It's self-aware. This is like self-awareness.
It's too much. It's too much for birds should not be self-aware.
See how the feathers back here, though, kind of
mm-hmm.
go up? Well, actually, I guess this. So I guess you lose the feathers back there?
Yeah.
I don't know. Also, something, you get a little crook. See that?
Yeah.
You get a little crook in the beak.
Bent.
Anyways.
Yeah.
Mareep.
Ooh, howl. Okay.
There's a sheep Pokemon.
I don't mind this.
I like it. Yeah, I like cute. I like the little old things on the side. Just a little like electric guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's okay.
All right.
Is this a maybe? Is this something that's...
Is there a evolve? I think there's an evolve. Should we check the evolve?
Yeah, let's see what it goes up to. Oh, my
Flaffy.
Gosh.
So it goes from four legs to two. The color. Tyler's going to really be bothered by the color change. Here, the
I love the name. Flaffy's pretty cool.
Flaffy's a good name, too. Yeah. Actually, I think I like the... is there a third one? Oh, there is. Okay. Ampharos is the third evolution here. So we lose all the fluffiness. Okay, so we started as a cloud.
Yeah.
A little electric rod.
Like a cumulus nimbus.
And then we turned into a
little
alto stratus.
Well, it's still cumulus, but smaller.
Okay. Still have the lightning pole. And then we just lose the fluff and get really serious.
Get tired
like, we're all happy. Like, what happened? This is just childish innocence, right?
How do you change
and then
your
this
color
is
three
just
times?
This is just joy. And then this is just seriousness.
Yeah, this is like no way just electrocute you. Yeah.
I would say the color change probably from getting repeatedly electrocuted so much.
Yeah. It's ironic because I think the horns and stuff make sense on the first two more than on this one, like on the last one. Like
on
I would have almost liked to see them just remove
this.
The horns. Yeah.
And then you don't like this though.
No, because it like you go
up.
From like a sheep to a sheep to a like giraffe or something. It is no. If we're picking one of those, I actually picked the first one. I like Marie.
I would as well. Is it good enough to be a maybe though? Very cute.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah, we can.
The real challenge is me going to be remembering what any of these look like as I'm just reading down.
Yeah, I might have to control F. Okay, Belle Awesome, which evolves from Gloom, so that's Gloom. So, it's an either or, I guess. So Gloom goes into Vileplume or Belle Awesome, I believe.
Yeah, Vileplume is very
Vileplume. Yeah,
yeah, that's very.
So this one's interesting, but it's just a departure from where Gloom is, you know what I mean? Like, this is just so weird.
Well, look, I'm not saying this is top five material, but I like the idea of, like, the problem is, like, when you have an Oddish, right? Because it Oddish is the first one.
Yep.
And then it goes into Gloom, and it's just, and then Vileplume. Like, it's just like you're getting progressively worse. And I like the idea of you have this alternative evolution where, like, you overcome your, like, severe depression, and now you're just this happy, carefree little plant.
Yeah, no, the Sunstone. Yeah, I do like that as well, right? Like, the sun.
Yeah.
This is what I view a Sunstone evolution as. Your joy.
Special mention. Yeah.
All right, so you want a maybe on this? You seem to care for it.
No. It's a special mention, and that's as much as I care about it. Yeah.
All right. Goodbye. Marill.
Marill? Merrill? Marill?
Merrill.
Merrill?
Yes.
I know this one too.
So this one's a baby, Pikachu. A baby, right? Of the other one. I forget what they're called.
Oh, is it?
Is it?
I don't think so.
Oh, no, it's not. Never mind. I'm thinking of something else. All right. Marill. Totally unique. It looks like a mouse with I don't know what the tail's doing. It seems really crazy to me.
It's like they started drawing a Pikachu and then got drunk.
Yeah. And really big sphere on the end of the tail. But it is cute.
Wait, scroll back up. Where do ears go? So ears just change from a mouse.
Yeah,
to
we're
a
looking
rabbit.
At the evolution now. So the next one is Azumarill. So the ears turn into bunny ears.
Yeah,
from the mouse ears, and then the appendages just get a little longer. So I like that it's consistent. The tail is consistent. I do like that. So it kind of grows into its tail. I like that. You see how the tail kind of stays the same. Yeah. And then it's just a big egg. It's just a big fat fucking egg.
This is a good evolution aside from the ears. If you took the Marill's ears and either grew into them or made them just laughably enormous, that would be a perfect evolution in my mind.
Yeah, that would be funny. Only 25 candy, so keep that in mind. I like the design here. The belly kind of gets a little more interesting than just the white.
Yeah, I mean, you're grown. You get the little tufts of fur, and yeah, sure.
So, how do you feel? Do you have, I don't know.
I can't put it on my top five just because. Okay. Well, obviously our top five, but I can't put it on there just because the bunny ears are killing me, man.
Okay, the bunny ears really get to you. I'm with you. Also, the Tyler hates fairies, so confirmed.
I don't hate fairies.
Hates them.
I don't not hate them.
All right, Sudowoodo.
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 Sudowoodo? I don't know. Whatever.
It's a no for me.
Yep.
It's ridiculous. It's a rock type, which is very interesting.
That's silly.
Look at this guy. This is silly, right? All right, here we go. So, Politoed.
Nope.
So, it goes from Poliwhirl.
That's
it. Wait a second. Is Poliwhirl the first one?
No, Poliwhirl is the last. Oh, wait. Yeah, it is. So it would be.
So this is another divergence.
Poliwhirl, and then it goes either Poliwrath.
Yeah, Poliwrath.
Politoed.
Or Politoed.
I appreciate the idea that it finally grows into like a frog versus just a bigger tadpole.
Yeah.
But I feel like you're starting to mess
with and stuff.
Yeah. Well, the problem is like you're starting to mess with like the OG stuff. So by default, like I don't mind this design, but when you're starting to tell me like, oh, well, we're actually going to throw out Poliwrath and replace it with like something like this. Mm.
I don't think it throws it out. I think it's still in the game, right?
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, you're starting to mess with something. Like,
yeah.
If you want to add an extra evolution beyond, fine. If you want, and I know I'm talking about this out of my mouth because I just did the Vileplume stuff, but
I think that's worse, right? Then you ruin Poliwrath.
Yeah,
but this is like a tree now.
Like that's a different enough character that you could have maybe just made that a evolution of a different tadpole.
Yeah, I agree. I am not a fan of it though.
Yeah.
It's like it looks weird to me. Hop Pip.
That's just, I don't even know. That's scary. Honestly, that looks like straight out of what's the one where you're running around sucking up slimes? Slime Rancher? That's a straight up Slime Rancher.
Slime Rancher?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I never picked this one up either, so I don't really have a.
It's possessed, man.
No.
You don't deal with it.
Yeah,
you
look at those eyes.
Don't deal with satanic stuff.
Does it have a evolution? It does. Skip Loom. No.
This should be in like the outtakes, right? Like this should be like, oh, we had an idea here, and they're like, nah.
It goes one more. Jump Fluff. Jump Fluff.
What are those like?
This is backwards,
like,
right?
What
isn't this like a?
No, I view that as like the old lady one, right? Like you're in your prime, and then you grow old.
You want to
pollinate and just
and
put the little
yeah.
seed in there or whatever, and then just die. I don't know.
I hate the design. It's terrible. I really.
It's
don't
like a
design.
Blueberry that's has
these
a,
are like
a really bad mold or something. Yeah,
this is like pom poms. I think that's kind of interesting, but
yeah, you could have rid of like the pom poms there. Just did maybe one at the top.
Yeah, it's a no for me on all these. Look
yeah,
how big these ears are. Like it goes from huge little ears, bigger ears, floppy, and then no, you lose all ears.
This is a three different designers worked on this, and they all worked on this. Like it's like, hey, you're gonna do the first, you're gonna do the second, you're gonna do the third, and they all did them together at the same time. It just
like a race.
Actually like build off each other.
All right. A palm, the monkey.
That's neat.
With a little I always like the
little slappies, with the little
gel
things.
Yeah, he picks things up with his tail because it's like a hand.
Oh, I meant the little things you got out of like vending machines.
Yeah. The sticky things. No, this was, he could pick things up and stuff. It's like a hand.
Yeah. I mean, it's cool.
Yeah, I never got him, but
a little sneaky
interesting
guy.
Design. Yeah,
sure.
Does he have an evolution? He does not. Anything from you or?
I mean, purely design wise, I could throw him on a maybe. I could see that. I like the idea that like his tail is basically his hand is his mode of movement and transportation. I guess. I'm
how cheeky he is. This guy's a cheeky guy.
Yeah.
All right, I'm good with a maybe there.
Is it weird that he seems more sentient than the other three above him just because he has like pupils?
Yes.
I don't know.
That's not weird. No, I agree.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Well, how do I spell his name before I go to the next month?
AIPOM.
All right. Apom.
Apom. Apu?
Yeah. Sure.
I don't know.
Apom.
I don't know. Anyways, Sunkern.
Okay. Scary.
Like a seed.
I feel like I would actually dig this design if you got rid of the mouth. The mouth is not.
It's like, hey.
Yeah. Like you got rid of the mouth.
He's going to have a face full of dirt.
Give him a mouth on his next evolution. Does he have an evolution?
Yes. Sunflora.
Yeah. Exactly. Perfect. That's a good evolution. I could see like the seed and then you bust into the sunflower.
Yeah. And Sunstone.
Yeah, but is the Sunstone in silver and gold, or is that like a?
Yeah, I think so.
Pokemon Gold.
I don't know if it
or Pokemon Go thing.
Might be a Pokemon Go thing. Well, the Sunstone is in those games. I think. I don't know if this one requires it in the games, but whatever.
I think the thing that I would do is like get rid of the mouth and the seed, and I would actually get rid of the stripes.
Yeah, the stripes are interesting to me
because
it doesn't. Yeah, I don't know.
You could, like, so the darker part of the yellow around the Sunflora, You could make that like the brown or the black. Or
here's whatever. A question I have for you. So this here's the sprout, right? And it grows into the green. But yeah. The green's his body.
Yeah.
So
it has some. It's a metaphor.
See where I'm coming from here?
Yeah, it's a metaphor. It's instead of growing the way you think you're going to grow, you turn out completely different, you know, and you're happy about it.
I see. Very happy. Look how happy he is. Everyone who evolves from a sunstone is the happiest.
It's just very, very positive. Yeah.
All right. Anyways, anything on this?
I don't care about either of those now. I feel like Plants vs. Zombies did that the sunflower better. So
Yanma is like a dragonfly.
It's a lot. I appreciate the. There's a lot going on there.
Like yeah.
It wanted to make a cool Dizzy. One. Yeah. Maybe get rid of the stripes on the wings. This somehow turned into, hey, let's redesign Pokemon.
I think the face is actually the most busy for me. I think maybe just simplify this. I actually like the stripes. Maybe make them red, though. I don't like the red and orange.
Yeah, either or. I mean, if you took out the little wings on, or not the wings, but the little tips on the bottom and like the two fins or whatever he has back there.
Yeah,
and,
yeah. Propellers. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Exactly. That's the technical
term. All right. Wooper.
Wooper's kind of cool.
Yeah, I like Wooper.
I like the idea of water ground. What makes him ground?
I don't know, but he was ground. I mean, the next one's one of my favorites, but I do like Wooper.
Does it evolve from Wooper?
Yes.
All right, well, let's see him up.
Quagsire. Yes.
Oh my gosh.
He's just a big guy. He's so happy.
That is yes. he seems very dopey, and I'm here for it.
I always got a Quagsire because he's just what he
is
got.
This gonna be the dark horse here.
I love them. I'm just being honest. I don't know why. I mean, look at him. Come on, look at him. Sure. Okay, here, like if I'm being actually critical, you know, you have like these things going on, like these little kind of things, and then they're just like, nope. It's just gonna be a big.
Well, it almost looks like they meld into his body and suddenly that's just his stuff on the back.
Yeah, but
If I'm being objective, I think Wooper is a better design.
I agree. I agree. But objectivity is not where the couch company is strong. So Quagsire gets my vote.
Quagsire grabbed our hearts. Okay.
Look at his big tail. It's just so big.
Yeah,
so like,
I don't even know that's like a tail. That's just something that they just
love
had.
This guy. Yeah,
it's like
it is
splitting. It's so big. It has like a
it's like a hot
stretch
dog.
Mark in the middle of it. Yeah.
All right. Ugh. Anyways, all right. Espeon is from Eevee,
ooh,
so they added an Eevee evolution.
Yeah.
Psychic.
Sure.
I'm not big on the psychic, but I do appreciate another Eevee evolution. I think.
Yeah, I like
favorite.
That idea. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, but this one gets the cake for me. So Umbreon is just super sweet. I love Umbreon, which is the dark version of Eevee. Very, very cool. Very sleek. I like the rings. I like the gold and black.
I don't know, man.
You don't like it?
It's not doing it for me. Do you like, is Umbreon like you're in your, you went on the maybe list?
I would, but I mean, if you're like, if you hate it.
It's okay. It's just like too like it. Maybe it's just me being like very basic and being like, well, it's yellow. We already have a yellow Eevee with Jolteon. Like it just doesn't seem like. I feel like if you're gonna do like a dark one,
it's
like
gold.
Maybe
it's
don't
gold,
pick,
isn't it?
Well,
it's
sure, gold. But you can't really do gold in like on print, you know. So it's like you should have done like I don't know, like dark and like maybe like a really deep purple or like something like that, but. It's, I mean, it's cool. Like, it is sleek. I just, it's scary, man. It's,
yeah, it's like, off-putting. It's like, it's Umbreon.
I guess what I'm saying is, if
like
you look
Shadow
at
the
that,
Hedgehog for Eevee,
if you look at that, I would have guessed that that's a variation of Electric. Where if you look up,
really?
The other
I disagree. I don't
well, know. I don't think about Dark either because I don't think they had Dark in first gen too.
Yeah,
psychic
I see
makes
dark.
Perfect sense.
Like
I'm
the
just
red,
yes, that is it.
The red eyes here, perfect with the black. I think
maybe if it was like they just got rid of the circles or something, or like the leg circles, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It makes it look more regal.
Yeah, sure.
My, it's like a little, my opinion. All right, like, I mean, if you hate it, we don't have to put it. I would personally put it on the maybe, but that's just,
I mean, I don't hate it. I'll put it on the maybe for you. That's all fine. Right. All right. If it was up to me, I would probably put the...
Do you like this one better?
I do like Espeon more than Umbreon. Yeah.
Would you put Espeon on the maybe then?
I would.
Instead of Umbreon?
I would, because I think that is a good use of, hey, we're pulling someone in from the first gen and we're expanding upon it without overriding what we've already accomplished. You're just getting more of it in a good way, I think. And you can make the same argument with Umbreon. I just don't think that Umbreon necessarily reads as dark for me, but I'm not as into that as maybe you are.
I mean, we can put Espeon on the maybe here. And
I already wrote Umbreon. We're good.
Okay.
We're good. Special shout out. I don't have like a horse in that race.
Murkrow.
Okay.
Dark flying, a little, yeah, little hat thing. Cool.
Is that actually a hat, or is there some weird...
That's like a brim, horribly...
I like think a, it's a skull.
Maybe it's skull? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know.
I feel bad.
Looks like, okay, a hat, though. And then we go to... oh, no, it's just one. It's just one.
Just that. Yep, sorry,
just,
buddy.
Just, yeah, all right. Yeah, it's not gonna...
I don't think there's too many...
All right, now we get Slowking, which is just fantastic.
Oh, man.
Evolves from Slowpoke. I mean, look at this guy. This guy is ruling over the nation.
It's, well, here's how I view this is, he has overcome that parasite on him and he has just owned it. He's like, I know what I am, and that is his crown now.
Or the parasite has taken full control of his brain.
Either one of those scenarios makes him incredibly cool.
The parasite has given him knowledge. And he has
if Quagsire goes on there, Slowking should go on there. But okay, there can only be one majesty. Like, that's, you know what I mean?
I don't see Quagsire as the king. I just see him as your friend, as your buddy.
Yeah, but Quagsire is a king. Anyway.
Right, that's not very good. Okay. I put him on the maybe, by the way. I put him on.
He's on there. He's on there. Yeah.
Mistravius.
Ghost. It's a cool design.
Interesting. I like creepy. The little highlights. I think that's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's like a nice, hey, Gasly needs a girlfriend. That's what I've used that, I'm sure. So is the idea that this Mistravius has male and female, like all of these are male and female, then you can just, they all look the same, but
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't remember this. Right. I mean, this looks female to me, right?
I feel like it's a feminine,
aren't there form female for... only Pokemon?
Well, in the first one, it was only, Nidoran and
male. That might be one of these. I really can't confirm or deny that though. So I don't know.
All right.
Unknown.
Ugh.
Are these all the letters? Did these not?
They did have letter ones at
okay,
some point.
Okay, there's just more. There's just more letters.
Yeah, I don't know if they were called unknown though. I don't remember.
I thought they were. I'm trying to remember, like the Pokemon movie. Dude, it's been so long. I have no idea.
It's like they took the glitch from the original game, and they're like, "Hey, what if we made a Pokemon out of it?"
Yeah,
the like missing no or whatever. Yeah, I mean, it's okay. I feel like that's just lazy. It's just like they even call it that. They're like, we don't know what this is. They just put
it's
in.
Like the ancient. It's, I don't know. All right, whatever.
Yeah, like on one hand, yeah, they're ballsy as heck for just being like, yeah, it's Pokemon now. Yeah. Cool, but
yeah.
Yeah.
Wobbuffet. This is another.
Is that a tail or a shadow back there that looks terrifying?
Tail. It's his tail.
Yeah.
Wobbuffet's famous. I mean, he's the doesn't he team up with Team Rocket, right? I like Wobbuffet.
I couldn't tell you. I never watched the show.
I think you told me you did once, but all right.
Not religious. I mean, I've seen an episode here and there, but not enough to know that Wobbuffet teamed up with Team Rocket.
Yeah,
how do you feel about him? You like him?
I like Wobbuffet. He's iconic. Cool. He's iconic, man.
Wobbuffet. I mean, I've never heard of him.
Wabba Fett. I put him on the maybe. I put him on the wavy.
All right, put it on
for me.
Done.
Okay. All right, done.
There is a giraffe. Cool.
Yeah, there is a giraffe. Jar Barig. Is that right?
I'm assuming that? It's a giraffarig.
Giraffarig. That'd be know. Too on the nose, though, wouldn't it?
You well, buddy. I think we're past that point.
Sure. All right.
Yeah, maybe.
Things I like about this. I like the two color approach here. And I like the tail. It's super creepy and very psychic-y. Everything else is just a giraffe, so I don't know.
Yeah, it's okay. The tail is a little weird. Like, are there two sentient beings there? Is the tail just like that's just
that's
like
a what I like about the psychic, right? Like, it's like weird. I feel like that's your chance to get weird with it, and they do. They do it here. They get weird.
Yeah, I feel like they could be weirder.
But, okay. Sure. Sure. All right. Anyways, moving on.
Yeah, it's okay. Ooh, what is this go? Pine cone.
Yep. I never ever got this guy ever. So.
I want to know the designer that just looked outside, saw a pine cone, and were like, "What if we called this a pine cone?" And they're like, "You can't do that." What if we called this a pine co? And then that's it.
Done. 204. Done. Book it.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I'm ready to move on.
It's fine. Yeah. Okay.
Oh wow, it has an evolution.
But it has an evolution that completely changes
Fortress.
Fortress. I actually like that design a whole lot. I don't know why. I think it's clean and cool looking, but it ticks me off that that's an evolution of Pinecone. Like there is zero relationship there.
Yeah, the evolution is really bizarre. It looks like he has like glasses on. He looks like a nerd.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, thanks. I feel like he could just close. Can he just close this? Maybe I don't know. I never got either of these. I'm good. It does go to a steel though, which is interesting. Steel type.
Yeah, it's just weird though. Like it's just there is zero.
I don't know. You can't. Both balls of defense.
Yeah, like one's a freaking pine cone and the other one is like a meteor.
I don't know. All right, let's move on. Dunsparce.
I feel like if you're just a normal Pokemon, like if that's your type, you just are immediately disqualified.
I think we have a normal one on here. We have the monkey.
I'm sure we do. I'm sure we do. I can't tell if, like, is it on its back? Is it just, like, sleeping? Is it just hanging out?
I don't know. I never understood this one. It's just...
It's like a dung beetle.
Yeah. Right. I'm good.
Yeah.
Gligar.
It's like they threw away a Golbat design.
Like a Golbat and a Scyther.
Like a Scyther, yeah.
Scyther.
It's okay. I feel like that it's kind of like a retooled design.
Yeah. He's ambitious though. I give him points for that.
Sure.
He looks like a superhero kind of.
Yeah.
All right, Steelix.
It's pretty
evolves
cool.
Evolves from Onix. He's a steel, and he's super awesome. And then I think he definitely deserves to be at least a maybe.
Sure. No argument there. I think it's kind of neat. Again,
I mean, take Onix and just make him steel and more.
Yeah, just make him cooler somehow.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah, exactly. Like, dude, oh my God. This guy has to weigh like a million pounds.
Yep.
It's pure steel. But he's steel and ground, which is interesting.
So he goes from rock to steel and ground.
Yep.
Weird.
Or is he rock and ground or steel and ground? I'm not sure.
No, I just think he was ground. I guess rock isn't really a type, is it? So I guess he would have been ground in the original. Yeah. I don't know.
Yep. Snubbull.
I don't know what to think of this.
The face bulldog, is
cool. Yeah.
Bulldog with a dress and it's angry probably at the designer, but who knows? this gets a question mark out of 10 for me.
Yeah, it's okay. It's like Disney wanted a crack at making a Pokemon.
You think they make him so angry though?
Yeah, it's like a don't know, like this is like a Team Rocket person, right? Like this is something that they join up with.
That seems about right.
Yeah.
Oh, it evolves into Grand Bull.
I'm pretty sure we've seen like a Tom and Jerry cartoon where that's the expression on the dog's face. Yeah.
Yeah. So he gets out of the dress. Grand Bull gets out of the dress and is kind of evil now. I mean, he's always been kind of mad, but now he's like laughing.
Like those aren't even teeth. Those are just your jaw turning.
Yeah, that's so they're the teeth. These are just jaw spikes. Yeah.
Don't like that.
That's crazy.
All right. Well,
Quillfish. So it's a puffer fish.
Yeah.
Looks like it'll mess you up.
I like the water poison combo.
Yeah, it's an interesting
doing some weird stuff with that. That's cool.
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
I feel like it's like a normal design.
Yep.
This guy's sick looking.
It's like this is on the Scyther. So you think Scyther, he's super badass, can't get any cooler. And then, you know, take a page out of Onyx, which is add some steel to him, and now he's freaking Iron Man.
Yeah.
So he is super awesome.
Changes color. So that's the point.
But in the defense here, we're adding a steel component, right?
So you're saying Scyther is underneath all of that. That's just like a hard shell.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
That's my interpretation.
I can get behind that.
Because look at Steelix. I mean, he just turns into steel. It changes color. Changes, just literally changes elements.
I'll give it to you.
All right, Shuckle.
Oh my gosh, I love this.
Really?
Can you just like pop his head out of like anything? Anything?
I think so. I think that's how it works.
Why do I like this so much?
I don't know.
Shuckle might be my pick. Like my keybone pick.
God, all right, do it. Then.
I'm putting that on the maybes. You. I just
all right. Heracross, a bug fighting. We always like the fight. I like the fighting. But this guy doesn't really do it for me. He's too bland, in my opinion.
I think it's a cool shape. I feel like you can do some other stuff to it, but I like that.
Okay.
I wouldn't put it on the list necessarily, but I like the... Yeah.
No, I think it's fine. I think it's fine. That's how I would classify it.
It looks better than most bug Pokemon from Gen 1 and 2, I would say.
Yeah, you know what? That's a really good point.
Like, if this was like a Gen 1, this might actually get talked about more.
Interesting. All right, how about Sneasel? Dark Ice, so we get a pretty unique pairing here.
It's cool.
I like the design. I like the two different color ears. Okay. I never got this one, though. I don't know why, but I think it's interesting, though.
It's nice. Does it evolve into anything?
Yeah, that's what I was checking. I was trying to see. It does not.
Oh. So
it's standalone.
It's nice. I don't know if anything's like screaming though, right? To me. Yeah.
Seems like it should. I feel like
it should have something before that one. Like that looks like a final iteration almost.
I say this would be one. I think this would be a twofer. This would be one, and then you get
it's like the teenage angst one.
Yeah. I don't know. It's the vibe I get, but all right. You feel strongly about
I don't. I don't know why. It's a good design. I just don't know why I don't care about it.
All right. Teddersa. It's a teddy bear.
That is a witch teddy bear. Like that's a cult Moon. Right there.
Yeah. Normal though, not even dark. Interesting.
Oh, yep. I want you to think it's normal till it turns dark. That's how it
turns
works.
Into Ursaring.
Okay.
He's the big bear with an oh. I like to think maybe the moon kind of completes itself. I don't know.
Yeah, I feel
moves from his face to his.
It's almost like it should have been like a crescent moon then turns into like a full moon or something.
Yeah.
Or it should have been on its stomach and not on its head.
Yep. Yep. It's a no from me for both.
Yeah, things. It's almost like they made the bear and they're like, this looks too boring. And they're like, what if we put a circle on his belly? Yeah, I'm good with this.
Yeah, yeah. Slugma.
Yes.
All right.
No, I'm kidding. This is hilarious. I love the eyes. It just looks terrified.
It is, yeah. It does evolve into this guy. Mag Cargo gets a little shell on his back.
Dude, this is like, this is hell, right? Like, I feel so bad for this guy because it's just like, you're just in constant torment the entire time.
I don't believe he has any nerve endings in the magma. If so, that would be very unfortunate.
Yeah, not anymore. He's gone.
He's just a rock.
Look at his eyes. He's literally terrified.
Gains a rock.
Yeah.
Now he gets the type. So that's kind of funny.
Do you like it? I like the Meg Cargo.
Oh, Meg Cargo.
Yeah. I just like
enough to put him on the baby.
Oh, dude. I'm looking at the list and I'm already forgetting half of these.
So. I mean, we'll go through it. We'll go.
Okay. Sure. All right. We'll put him on.
All right. How about Schwinnab?
I feel like it's in pain. It's uncomfortable sleeping. To look at.
Sleeping.
Yeah, but I feel like if you're sleeping but your eyes are going up that way, it looks like he's sad more than sleeping. Like he's like in a deep depression.
He's ice. He's cold.
This should be like the first evolution of I don't even know its name. Centret, maybe. Yeah. Little bunny, fat bunny.
But then it goes into pillow swine. Now you can't even see its eyes. You don't even know if it's sad.
Yeah, I'm guessing it's probably still sad.
Probably.
It's cool design. It's fine.
Tusks. It gets huge.
A little baby mammoth and the bigger mammoth. It's okay.
Big ears, too. Look at this. No ears to big flop.
Just big floppy ear. Man. Yeah.
Yeah. Get some meat on him.
It's okay.
All right. How about Corsola?
What is that? Like a coral?
A coral.
Yeah. It's okay.
Yeah, it's fine, I guess. How about a Remoraid?
I feel like it's getting less inspired personally. It's like, oh, we saw a fish.
Yeah, it's like a minnow.
Yeah.
I think. Isn't this? I don't know.
You just add the horn at the end.
Yeah. When in doubt, just a little horn. All right. How about Octillery?
I like it. Reminds me a lot of Splatoon as of late.
Yeah, I think he uses this as like a artillery piece.
So wait, it evolves from... Wait, scroll up. So it's evolving from
above. Oh, wow. Yeah, I didn't realize that.
Then that's a big nope for me, dog.
Remoraid, the fish goes into an octopus.
No. Octillery. That disqualified immediately.
Okay. Delibird.
Just Santa Claus owl.
Yeah, penguin, kind of penguin.
Penguin. Okay, yeah, good call. Yeah. Good call. Santa Claus penguin
with a tail.
It's cool.
Oh no, is it a bag?
It looks like a bag, but it might be a tail.
Yeah, it's got a bag. I don't remember this one. That's cool,
I definitely
though.
Remember it, but that's Santa Claus.
Do you like Santa Claus?
Not particularly.
All right, we'll move on. This is what I was thinking of. So Mantine.
Mantine's neat.
So it has a little called. Is that a Remoraid? Am I crazy? Right?
Is it?
Yeah, it has to, right? Right? Like,
looks like
he
it.
Is.
Yeah.
And then he is. Yeah, he's cool. Water flying. That's interesting.
Yeah, I like the idea that that's just kind of, he's just like kind of sailing around above the ocean.
Yeah. Yeah, I always liked Mantine. I think I always had one.
Do they evolve into anything?
No.
Interesting. I mean, is this a top five given everyone we just put on the list?
I mean, we have a lot. Yeah. We should probably be a little more selective.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's cool. I think the thing that makes it cool is the water flying. If it wasn't water flying, I'd probably pass on it, regardless. So
yeah. All How about Scammery? Skarmory.
I don't know why I put this next to like an Aerodactyl. And it just, yeah, I agree.
It has potential, dude. Steel flying.
Yeah.
Steel is so super cool, right? Like, steel is one of the coolest types, in my opinion. So
if you talked to me in 2001, this would be probably a bigger
like, deal.
Fight, yeah.
Interesting. I don't think I was big on Skarmory, so I don't know. I mean, I don't think I ever like prioritized this one in my game. So I'm good with passing.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm good pass.
How about Houndour?
Houndour's kind of cool. What's
yeah, that? I like Houndour.
Is that literally a skull on his head? Is this like a Cubone situation?
I am unsure.
Are his bones
are these rib
him?
Bones on his back? Yeah, I don't know.
That is badass, man.
He is cool, though. Dark Fire. He's serious. I know he does evolve, so let's take a look at the evolution. So Houndoom. Yeah, that's where it gets.
Yeah, now you're doing like a Hellhound-looking thing.
Pretty crazy. I do like the skull on the chest.
I would take first one if we had a pick.
It's another ring. You know what? I might agree with you, although I do like Houndoom quite a bit. I think it is cool. You get like the kind of the devil horns collar.
Because I never played this one, but this would be the one that gets it banned from Christian pub, like private school.
Yep.
Right.
Yep.
It's like, oh, this is a Hellhound. Got it.
Yeah. Yep. 100%.
So which one do you want on the
list? I like the first one, although I do like both, actually. I think it's very consistent too. Like, this is a nice evolution, I would say, right?
Yeah.
But
yeah. No, I think that's a good one.
If you want to add it to the maybe.
This feels like this could be in Gen 1. Like, it's like a classic Pokemon thing. Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. How about Kingdra? Chevals from Seadra.
I think somebody that did like Kingbro or whatever and was just, hey, what if we did that for another one?
Yeah. Yeah.
Its face looks weird to me. I don't know.
Very intense. I don't know. I'm not big on it either, so I'm good to pass.
Yep. Pass on that.
How about Phanpy?
I love this.
Little elephant.
That is the cutest Pokemon that I've seen yet.
Interesting. It's a ground type, which is kind of surprising to me.
Yeah.
I think this evolves too. So let's Donphan. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I
remember.
That's right. Okay. Yeah. It's coming back to me.
Oh, no. Yeah. That makes me so sad. Like, that actually makes me the saddest I've been in quite some time.
Oh, yeah.
Look how carefree and joyous, and it just turns into hatred and
I would call it toughness rather than hatred.
Yeah,
like. But the cool thing about Donphan is I think it can like roll up, kind of roll, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, it certainly looks that way,
which is super cool. The joy leaves its heart, but it does make up for that.
Yikes.
Straight combat ability. Also, very big color shift here. You literally see the light leaving.
That's what I mean. Yeah, like it's
it goes to a neutral tone.
Feels so bad. And look at it. Look at its nose. Like, you see even like the tusks. They actually haven't come through yet. They're just starting.
Yeah. Right here.
I don't know if that's actually the case, but
yeah. I don't think so. I think it's just a smile,
but mouth. But yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I like the little elephant.
You want to put Phanpy on?
Phanpy? Yeah.
Phanpy. Phanpy?
All right.
Phanpy? It's Phanpy. Sorry.
I think Phanpy.
Okay. I know I'm triggered. Man, I'm horrible at pronunciation. So
I'm using phonics for
Tyler insisted that I drove, so here we are. All right, next up. Porygon 2.
So here's the cool thing with this one. Okay. I would not put it on the list, but
nope.
I do appreciate them taking this very polygonal thing and being like, all right, here's the 2.0. And it's very Apple, right? It's just super slick, rounded everything. There is a certain beauty to it that I actually think is kind of clever.
I'm the opposite. I hate it. Because to me, Porygon has always been like Polygon, like it's supposed to be that way, and now it's just like, what are we doing?
Yeah, well, hey man, look, the computer was always supposed to be a certain way, and then Apple came along, right?
Okay.
I'm not saying this belongs on the list, but I think it's a clever.
It should be the Porygon.
Something. But it's just a clever nod to. I'm sure that's not even the reason why they did it, but it's clever.
All right, good shout out. How about Stantler?
I don't even know what to make of this one. That's a no for me, but like, okay.
All right. How about Smeargle,
painter?
Yeah, Smeargle.
Yeah,
I thought the painting with the tail is pretty interesting.
It's neat. What is that? A goat or a dog or what?
Oh, like a hybrid. Like I a like monkey? The little artist hat too that it has.
Yeah,
which is cool. So the very very poignant design.
Yeah, I don't know if I love it enough to put on top five, but it's neat.
I don't, but yeah. I shout out. How about Tyrogue? Looks like a football player. I don't remember this one. I'm like forgetting all of these, man. Like what?
Is this a starting evolution?
Oh, it is. Okay. So it does. I remember the evolution here, but so it evolves into Hitmontop. I don't get the evolution, but I always did enjoy Hitmontop.
Yeah, but Hitmontop's not as good as Hitmonchamp or Hitmonlee, though.
No, right? But it's like the closest thing I can get in Gen 2.
Yeah, sure, but it's a...
Dude, just imagine Hitmontop spinning on its head and just kicking people. I mean, that's...
Oh, that's kind of neat. Yeah.
Yeah, right? That's what it does. It's like a fighting style.
Yeah. So it's literally a top.
Yeah. Yeah. So it spins, and it's just like a continuous kick.
Is that like a top five worthy thing? Like the thing that kills me is like A, the evolution is just atrocious, and yep. B, I don't think it's as good as Gen 1.
Okay,
which obviously is what it's trying to be.
Yeah. I got you. All right. How about Smoochum? the little Smoochum?
Smoochum's pretty good. An ice psychic? Look at that.
Does this
combo.
Go to this doesn't go to Jinx or something, right?
I don't think so.
It would probably say it. Ice Psychic, yeah, interesting.
Yeah. Okay, with that.
Like Smoochum? That's
funny. Yeah.
Maybe.
Smoochum is a maybe? Dude, we have so many other babies.
Imagine getting knocked out by Smoochum.
Okay.
How about Elekid? That's actually a no. It's like an outlet.
Is that going into Electrobuzz? Is that the starting, I think?
No, I don't think so. I think it's its own thing, actually, but...
Oh, really?
Yeah, I would say if it goes into something, wouldn't it?
Well, not if it's the starter.
Oh, you're right. I should look it up, I guess. I should look up Smoochum, too, because it looks like Jinx, doesn't it?
No, I think there is a different one for Jinx. I could be wrong, but...
Smoochum. I'm going to look up Smoochum first. Smoochum.
It's just very
sassy. It's a baby, yeah.
It's a baby Jinx?
Yeah, it evolves into Jinx, yeah.
Oh, yeah, wow. Okay.
Yeah. Because Jinx has the big lips too, right? I mean,
yeah, but Jinx looks completely different than that.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yes. Come on.
Dude,
color
no
shifts.
Way.
No hair. Like it's a well. Way. I guess it has hair, but it's like a weird.
A way.
Yeah. I would actually be okay taking Smoochum off the list, just knowing
that. Wow.
To be honest.
All right. Take it off.
First one off the list.
All right, how about Elekid? Let's see what that one is.
I was never a big fan of Electrobuzz. I actually like this more than Electrobuzz.
Yeah, it goes into Electrobuzz, you're right. Good call up.
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan, though, still.
Nah, I'm good.
How about...
This would go to Magmar, I would assume.
Yeah.
Not a big fan
Magby.
Of.
Magby? Magby? Magby?
Magby. I'd say Magby.
Mag goodbye, because you're not on the list.
Zing.
Yeah, that was a little mean. All right, let's keep going. How about Milk Tank? Milk Tank. It should be called Milk Tank.
Milk Tank.
But it is called Mill Tank.
It's cute.
I like it.
It's teaching kids about some udders.
It's a cow, dude. I mean, that's nothing else to it. It's just cow. Sure.
It's got a cow, right?
It's got no. It doesn't. No, it doesn't. It's just
really?
A cow.
Wow.
It's just a cow. It's literally just a mill tank.
So what is this? The is that like a Genghis Khan type of thing, or is just like this just one?
I think it's just a cow. If I'm being honest with you, I think it's literally it's what it is. It's just a cow.
No, I know, but I'm saying like, is it the equivalent of like a Genghis Khan, where it's like, oh, it's just this one evolution that just happens to be there. Yeah.
Well, it's just a one off. Yeah, it's just a one off.
It's cool. I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Oh, it has a, so it's female only. And then Tauros is the.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was thinking Tauros, not Genghis Khan. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah. So this is the female. Yeah, I gotcha. Okay. Yeah. So this is the female.
Tauros is cooler. Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. All right. How about Blissey?
Oh, my goodness. Blissey? I like Chansey more. I'm just gonna say.
Really?
Yeah.
Is this too much? Too much.
Too much.
Yeah. Too much.
The egg looks weird now.
Did it get even bigger?
The whole thing with Chansey is like the egg was pretty big, and you just kind of hide the egg. Now the egg's like a belly button.
Now the egg's getting suffocated. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Fair. I don't like that. No. What?
Raikou? Is it Raikou or Raikou?
Yeah. Sure. I mean,
it's one of the legendary. This is a legendary, right?
Is it?
Yeah. It's one of
the worst That's the worst legendary I've ever seen.
Okay, that's a bold statement. I apologize.
Look how much is going on. Like, tell me I'm wrong.
No, I think I like NT. I forget.
Yeah, NT is at least cool. Like, I can follow the design a little bit. Got a little mustache going on. Looks like a walrus with a cat.
Yeah, I think that's my favorite.
Like, scroll back up. Okay. Like that, like this is insane. Like this is like what what are you doing?
There's a lot going on there.
Yeah.
It's I think if you get rid of the purple, I think we're good.
Bare minimum.
Make it white.
Dude.
Make it white.
Like, make that white and get rid of the, I would honestly probably get rid of the blue.
The blue, yeah, get rid of the blue, make it electric, and then the black should be more zigzaggy.
I don't even mind the black. Yeah, probably, but I don't mind the black. It's just like, yeah, that's
well, yeah. I mean,
Raikou is the worst legendary Pokemon. Prove me wrong.
Okay.
Yeah. NT's growing on me. I might actually put that on the list.
I feel like I'm pronouncing it totally wrong. I cannot remember. This guy was in the movie too, so I should know how to pronounce this one.
Entei?
I don't know.
Okay.
All right. Cool. Anyways, cool. He's my favorite out of the three. But here's the third one, Suicune. Yeah.
But like, even this, I don't love this design, but I can understand like the flowing water and stuff.
I like the. I like the kind of.
Yeah, I think it must be the colors for that
ribbon
that Riku or like whatever.
They all have these like the hair.
Yeah, I see what they're doing. It's just like that first one was bad.
All right. Anyways, this gets my vote for maybe.
Yeah, I'll put it on the list for maybe. That's fine.
All right. How about Larvitar?
It's okay. I feel like that would have been a cool starter grass Pokemon. I know it's
he's
rock
a rock ground.
Ground
so
like,
yeah,
yeah. No, I get that. No,
I agree, dude.
Looks green.
If rock ground was a starter, I would agree.
Oh, can you imagine if that was the thing? It's like you start off with like psychic ice or like rock.
Yeah.
And then just go.
It'd be awesome.
Yeah, it'd be cool.
Does he evolve? Yeah, he evolves into poop.
Something worse.
Poopitar.
Okay.
It's like the poop eye phase.
This is like a cooler looking of Metapod, which is not a compliment.
Yeah, but then he goes into Tyranitar.
Yeah, Tyranitar's all right.
Becomes dark.
Yeah.
You don't like Tyranitar?
He's cool.
I think he's cool.
I think that they're trying to
how
they
keeps
look
some
at
of his cocoon as his plate. Is his plate mail? Is that cool?
Yeah, but they looked at like things like Rhyhorn and not.
Look
Rhyhorn.
At this. You get the little soft underbelly.
Yeah.
Of Larvitar, and then it cocoons up.
Yeah.
Gets mad, even more mad, and it comes up.
Yeah, but it's crazy. It's that like it cocoons technique. Up, but there's no like plant based stuff there or bug based stuff, I should say.
He's a rock. What are you talking about?
I know it's no, but like, okay, you're a rock. You cocoon like rocks don't cocoon.
This one does.
Bugs do. Yeah. All right.
All right.
You're whatever. Telling me that doesn't look like a Nidoking? Like they get the Nidoking and they're like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if we had green one of those?
Fine. Okay. Fine. You win. You win, Tyler. Gen 1's just superior.
No. Do you want him on the maybes?
No, I hate him.
Oh, okay. Me too. I hate him.
He would
honestly out of this entire list, the only one I hate is the Raikou or whatever he had up top.
Oh my god, that is all right. Lugia.
Yeah, stupid. Look at those hands.
Wow.
I'm just kidding. I will give credit that it actually has five fingers.
True. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lugia is legendary.
Yeah, I know. Everyone loves Lugia.
Dude, Lugia is sweet. It's
better than the other one.
Maybe. Yeah, Ho-Ho is
dorky. Like I've seen better starter area Pokemon. Like Pharaoh looks better than that.
I like the colors.
Sure.
Very bright. Yeah, I mean, I got scammed, Lugia, right? Like
L-U-G-A. Yeah. Okay.
My brother got.
Yeah, you chose poorly on Lugia. That one.
I didn't choose. Dude, I was the younger brother.
Was better.
I was the younger brother. I got the second. I got the leftovers, man.
Yeah.
What are you talking about, man? How about Celebi?
Yeah.
All right.
Celebi was a rare something or other that you could get, right? Like
I guess like I don't I have, like I don't remember, dude. I vaguely
remember that. I got one of those, but it was like later on. It was like in like a GameStop giveaway or something.
Yeah, after going through this list again, Gen 3 is definitely I like Gen 3 more.
We'll see you here in another year and you can start fighting for Yeah. Like.
Anyways, all right, so we have our list.
We have a lot, yeah. So, Sentret. Probably should have put the number next to it, which would have helped you out a lot. You could do a Command F. Can you do a Command F to do a little... Control F if you're on a Windows PC.
Sentret. How do you spell it?
Yeah. S-E-N-T-R-E-T. Cosplay Central. There it is. Sentret. How do we feel about Sentret? So, Sentret, Crobat... which is the evolution of Golbat. How do you want to do
this? Is there anything that's a lock? Let's put our locks on, and then that'll kind of help us determine where we're at.
Sure. So, obviously, Quagsire.
Quagsire's a lock for me. I don't care what anyone says.
We'll put it in.
That's actually my favorite Pokemon from this generation. I'm not even joking. He's such a beast.
There he is. Yeah, I don't know. I like looking through here, the only ones that I somehow feel connected to is Phanpy, the little elephant. Because I feel terrible. I feel just so bad for it.
Okay.
I don't have a better defense for that one.
Sure.
How do you like Steelix? You like Steelix? Steelix is pretty cool.
I think Steelix should be on the list, yeah.
People are losing their minds right now.
Why?
I don't know. Like, I don't know. Is it
Steelix? Is though, find me someone who doesn't think Steelix is top five.
Fair
in
enough.
Gen 2, dude.
Okay.
Now, Phanpy. Oh, wait. What about Skizer, dude? We have to have Skizer on there, too.
Please tell me we just have a bunch of like steel and like badass Pokemon, and then you just have Shuckle. Shuckle was my dark horse until Phanpy came along, and then I feel like Shuckle can survive Phanpy. Although, wait, go back up to.
Did
I even put it on?
That cargo.
I don't even think I put it on because I knew I'd take him off eventually. Yeah. Oh no, I did put him on. So we're taking him off.
Yeah. All right. Well, let me just
poor Mag Cargo.
Let's just start eliminating people, I guess.
I will take Mag Cargo off.
This is too much. Okay, yep. So we have. Oh my god!
I am good taking Pichu off. Does not
take Sentret out too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Shout out for being our first one on the list.
Yeah, Sentret's out.
Taking Crobat out too.
Crobat out. Okay.
Yeah. It's cool, but not enough to be like, oh, okay, this is definitely an evolution.
Yeah. I do shout out Crobat. I really like Crobat. All right. Pichu, I think, is out.
Yep.
As well.
I agree. Togepi needs to stay on the list because of the. Okay. And maybe it is just because Misty had it.
Yeah. I like I think it's iconic. I think you're right. I think maybe the one of the most famous in this gen.
Next to maybe Lugia. Yeah, I agree with you.
Okay, we'll keep that on.
What about Mareep?
We can get rid of Mareep.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Yep. I just realized how many we have. We got to be a little
Apom. Here. That little Apom guy.
Where is
That's
he?
The little monkey.
Oh,
guy.
The monkey.
Yeah.
I'm good with taking him off too.
Me Shout too.
He was cool. All right.
So what Quagsire else? Is a lock. We'll keep him on.
He's got to be there. He's got to be here. What about Umbreon? People are going to get so mad when
my heart says Espeon personally.
Okay,
I'm drawing more to Espeon.
Let's put Espeon on the maybe here, and we'll get rid of Umbreon. How many do we have maybe so far? Let's just keep going. Okay. And then we'll see how many we're left.
What about Slowking?
Oh, this is so tough. I love Slowking, man.
You love it more than Quagsire. Not that you can't have both, but I feel like we already have the dopey thing filled.
How do you feel?
It's tough because Quagsire is new and I feel like you liked him a lot. I would obviously be more drawn to Slowking just because I think that's a cool, that's a good evolution. And either he's possessed or he's overcome his possession. Like he like ridded himself of it and then he took it as a trophy and used it as a crown.
keep it on for now.
About Wobbuffet?
We can get rid of Wobbuffet, but okay. Definitely shout out to Wobbuffet.
That's okay. Steelix is definitely on.
I think Steelix needs to stay.
Skizzer.
I think Skizzer needs to stay. Shuckle.
We can get rid of Shuckle. I've changed
allegiances. Very good. How about Matt Gargo?
Nah, you're talking him off. I feel bad. He's too far gone. He's in hell forever.
He is. Houndour. I'm good with getting rid of Houndour.
Yeah, Cubone's cooler.
Yep. Phanpy.
Look at Phanpy. I feel so bad.
Keep it on.
Feels so bad.
And then
Entei.
Is this crazy? Like I think he's getting booted. Is that insane? That might be the most insane thing I ever said, but I don't care.
I think that's okay. We have to come up with three, and we have six. So we need to nix three things out of Togepi, Espeon.
Is that it? Are we back to the...
Lugia is on there, too. Yeah.
So we need three.
So out of Togepi, Espeon, Slowking, is it Scizor? Skizzer?
Skizzer.
Skizzer? That's probably wrong. Yeah. If it's Scyther, okay. If it goes to Scyther, I assume it would be Scizor, but maybe not.
You're probably right.
Scizor, Phanpy, and Lugia. I think Togepi has to be on the list.
Okay, put Togepi on the list then.
Okay.
So now how many spots do we have? We have two.
We have two spots open.
Out of?
Espeon, Slowking.
Slowking.
Scizor, Phanpy, and Lugia. Yeah. It's probably just Scizor, right? Not Scizor, just Scizor.
Yeah, I think
Scyther and Scizor.
Yeah. Okay. So how many do we have and how many do we need? We need two and we have what? Five?
We have three out of the five. We need two.
I understand.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, we have five. We have five maybes. Yeah.
Okay. So we have Scizor, Scizor.
Yeah, we'll call him Scizor. We'll call him Scizor. Scizor's right.
And Slowking, which is fantastic. And Lugia, Lugia has to make it though, right? Like, I don't think we can.
I feel like just out of popularity, maybe. But then, are we really going to put up Espeon, Slowking, Scizor, and Phanpy? We're gonna fight.
Does Phanpy have to make the list for you? Does Phanpy have to make the list?
No, I just feel real bad.
Phanpy has had a rough time of it.
If I'm going to pick out of all of those, I would put Espeon on.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? Interesting.
Yeah.
I thought you didn't like Espeon.
No, I don't like your one.
Empyreon. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. We can put Espeon on, so then we need one more.
No, that would be all of them. We keep Lugia.
Oh, shoot. Then Scizor loses.
Yeah, Scizor and Slowking would both get nixed, yeah. Does Steelix have to be on over Scizor?
Oh man, that's so tough. I mean, if you had to pick between the two, who would you go with?
I would go with Steelix because Scissor just seems like, hey, let's paint him red and give him.
Yeah, but it's not red. It's literally a metal suit.
Yeah, I know. I just think that's, well, look, honestly, but you could make the same argument for both of them. I don't think either design is inspired personally.
True.
I think so Scyther would you take looks both cooler. Off
and then put on someone else like Slowking.
I would take both off and put Slowking and Phanpy on in a heartbeat.
Well, it would be ridiculous.
Well, right now we have Steelix on, so I would take Steelix Scissor off.
Oh, Scissor's on?
I would take Steelix and Scissor off and put Phanpy and Slowking on. Oh, no, wait, I'm an idiot. I'm sorry. Togepi, Quagsire, Espeon, Slowking, and Lugia would be the five.
Right.
Yes, I would do that.
I do love the steel, though. This is really difficult for me.
So you
can't sacrifice Quagsire, though. I'm too biased. I have way too much invested in this.
Would you sacrifice Lugia?
Personally, yes.
Yeah, take him. I have no love for Lugia. I don't care. Okay. I would fight for Togepi over Lugia.
Please give us 5 stars on Spotify, by the way.
So we're putting Scissor on. So we don't even know how to pronounce the name, but we're going to put it on the list.
Dude, he's sweet. I don't
Togepi,
know what to tell you,
Togepi, man. Quagsire, Espeon, yeah. Slowking, and Scissor. That's our five.
But I want Scissor or Steelix. I mean, it's between the two. I like Scissor more. I'm just trusting my gut. Both are amazing. But
see you,
like
Steelix.
Sorry, dude. It's just, he's just so awesome.
So now the question becomes, what is number five?
Normally how we do this, if something barely makes it on, I feel like it's usually five. Although yeah, I will
say... Is it barely making it on, or is it just your indecisiveness?
It might be my indecisiveness. That's true. All right, go through them again. Togepi,
Quagsire, Espeon, Slowking, Scissor. Maybe Scissor, Scissor. Scyther, Scizer? I don't know.
I mean, this guy can't be five, right? Like, he's too good.
He's better. Yeah, he's good.
He's better. What about Espeon at five? Is that crazy?
Espeon's pretty good.
It's not going to be Quagsire. What about Togepi? What about Togepi at five?
I feel like Togepi deserves more, but I'm fine with it being at five.
All right,
You said that from the very beginning.
I love that guy.
All right, Togepi is number five.
All right, perfect. I want to put Steelix on instead of Togepi. Oh my god.
I would probably fight you on that. Togepi is literally the only one I knew. He's cool. He's cool.
Huge. He's
Dude,
huge.
You can put him on in a heartbeat. You just need to get rid of Scissor. At least you know how to say Steelix.
That's true, but I won't.
Through 150 Pokemon. And
all right. Anyways. So Togepi five, and then does that mean Quagsire is going to be four? Because you won't allow him any higher. Look at this guy.
I like Quagsire. I'd put him up.
How can you say no?
Tell you what, man. You want Quagsire at like maybe like a three spot?
Who's four though?
Scissor? Or you love Scissor?
I'll put Scissor at four.
All right.
If Quagsire gets three,
I'm good with that.
And then will you put Espeon as two? Two? They're gonna be so mad. All hail the king.
So just so I'm making sure we're chiseling this in here.
Oh my god!
Or do you want me to run through before we chisel? So okay, so funny. Number five is Togepi. Number four is Scissor or Scizor.
Yeah.
Number three is Quagsire.
I feel like I should be
number two is Espeon.
As you're saying them, but
you probably should, but that's fine. And number one would be Slowking. You want to click on Slowking, give him full screen, make sure that it's everything that we hope and dream. What's he got in his little hand back there? Like, what's he holding? Is that his claw?
Is that his nail? Is it a nail?
Is that the parasite's soul?
He's just going to say this in here. No, but I'm loving every second of it. Look at him. He's conquered it. You're exactly right. Your theory is right. He has conquered it, or he's completely brainwashed. I don't know.
Look, man, all I have to say is there's no more eyes on the parasite thing.
Yeah, like, that's a good point. Like what was it on his tail?
Yeah,
it was on his tail, and then he put it on his head. I think you're right. I think he conquered it. And it's like, out of a group of slow pokes, the one who conquers the parasite leads the rest.
Yeah. Well, does a slow poke have a parasite on it, or is that just slow bro? Because isn't it a cloister on his thing, technically, or it used to be, or something?
What's the first one? Slowbro?
Slowpoke, then it goes to Slowbro. It's just the two.
Slowbro has it on his tail.
Yeah, I think Slowpoke doesn't, if I'm not mistaken.
Slowpoke.
So all the Slowpokes are the regular ones, and then Slowbro gets it, and then he overcomes it.
And then he overcomes it. What a story. All right. there we go.
Oh, man.
People are going to hate us.
Yeah, yeah. This is not a good list, but it's our list, and it's happy with it.
Well, there you go.
So Togepi number 5, Scizor number 3, Quagsire number... Wait, hold on.
That's not how numbers work.
Yeah, Togepi number 5, Scizor number 4, Quagsire number 3, Espeon number 2, Slowking number 1.
Yep, there it is. Officially, that is the 5 best Pokemon according to science, and there really isn't any counterpoints to that.
It's just objective stuff, man.
That's objective truth. Slowking is the king of Gen 2, and that's all we got.
That's it.
So thanks for joining us. If you made it this far, give us a 5-star on Spotify for the Slowking.
Yeah, hopefully the video goes well.
Yeah,
otherwise, I feel like the audio, well, who knows?
Maybe, the problem is at the end, I was kind of all over the place trying to recap them, but it's okay. It's our first time doing it. So,
yeah, we'll see.
All right, anyways, check us out, couchcompany.games. All of our links are there. Got a YouTube, got the Twitters, got the everything. All of our lists as well. And then we'll be back. Same time, same place next week. Although this week was a little different.
It was Wednesday, yeah. So it'll be Monday.
Monday. We'll be back. We'll be back on it. So thanks for joining us. The Game Awards coming up. We do have the Game Awards coming up. I'm excited.
I keep interrupting your spiel. I'm sorry.
No, you're good.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all I got. Sign us out.
Peace. Tyler.